everybody, and welcome back to another video. Today's a bit of a different video, because I'm not really doing any games and stuff. I couldn't really be bothered without any of that stuff, so let me just start. So, on the trading forum, I post regularly, so if you find me there, it's no big surprise, because I post regularly. I was looking around on the trade forum, and I've been looking quite a long time for a rainbow origami hat, and just, believe it or not, I just got it today. Maybe half an hour ago, but before recording this. So before that, I sent a trade to this dude, and I was asking for his rainbow party hat, and I was offering him a reasonable trade, and so he friends me after I sent the trade, and so I message him when he's online, and I ask him what he thinks about the trade, and he says, wait, okay, and then I ask if it's a decent trade. He proceeds to not answer that question, and then he says, I have one question for you, and I say, go ahead, and he asks whether I'm selling my bandana, my mythical bandana, and he asks for $17, and I say no, because I don't think that's worth. And then he asks why, because I would sell it higher, because it's such a good effect. And he asks how much I want, and he says he has $45. And so I say around $25, and he asks if I have PayPal, I say no. So, he then asks me how old I am, and I give him some random bullshit age. And so he says, okay, so accept the trade offer now, because he sent a trade offer with my mythical bandana for nothing. And I told him to do it through the market, and I'll list it at $25. And I said I'll lose money, and then he says, I'll give you $30 for it. And he says, because I see you're a nice guy. And then he says, I sent you a trade offer, and accept, and you will get $30 through Steam. And I ask how, and he says, I know how. This is getting sketchy already. He says, $30, okay. And then I say, how am I supposed to know that you'll give me $30 after, or will you just take it and block me and unfriend me and move on? I don't know at this stage how he's going to do any of this stuff. Anyway, he says, no, dude, I'm 21 years old. I'm not a scammer. How sketchy does that sound? Like, that's just... Oh, man, I wish he could just look at himself and, like... He might not be a scammer, but it just sounds so sketchy. And so he says, so you want $30 or not, dude? And he asks me why I'm so nervous, and I say, well, it's a mythical, like... You know, you don't just get this effect every day. And, you know, I'm worried that I'll get no money. And then I say on the market, and then, you know, if you want to go to look on my Steam profile and you know how much plus rep I have, how am I supposed to trust that? Because people on, like, on just the Steam forum, they say, oh, I'll do plus rep for a plus rep. So if you plus rep them, they'll plus rep you back. So I don't know. And then I say, you know, I lose $4 if I stick it up on the market, but I don't really mind. And so I'll put it up for $30, and I ask him, will I put it up for $30 or not? Anyway, he says yes, and then I say, all right, I'm listing it now. And he says, yeah, and then I'm confirming it on my slow-ass Android thing. And if you confirm fast, you will get $30 faster. It's getting sketchy. And I say, all right, and I've created the listing on the market. And then you could buy so many more skins for $30, which is what I was going to do. Pretty much. I was just going to sell it to him if he was going to do it on the market, and then I'll just buy another one because there's $17. And then he says, okay, if you don't want $30, buy. And I ask, so you want $30 on it? And I say, yes, I do. And if you have trade offer, I'll give faster money on your Steam. I don't know, because the market is just as fast. All you got to do is pay the money on the market, and then, you know. And then I tell him, well, if you bloody buy it already. And then he asks, so you don't trust me? And I say, he sounds like a nice dude, but I can never be sure. If it was a smaller skin, like an epic or a legendary, I would probably do it, but it's a $30 mythical. And then he says, dude, I promise you I will give you $30. Promising doesn't mean anything. And then as he says, if you accept trade offer, you'll get $30 and you can buy more mythicals. If you go onto the market and you buy it, I'll also get $26. I lose $4 and I don't really care. And he says, I don't want to buy from the market. Why does he not want to buy from the market? Because it's safe? Like, I really don't understand at this point. Anyway, he says, not from the market. So, how sketchy is that? And then he says, can you call me through Steam? Or can you call to me? I make a joke. And then he says, because I want to buy, not from that, because I want to buy from you, not from the market. And then that kind of call, you know? And then he says, so we can talk about it. And I say, no. And then, you know, and then I say, it sounds a bit sketchy because all of a sudden $30 is just going to pop up into my account. And then, yeah, I say, sorry if I've offended you because I don't trust you, but, you know, no matter the person, I would do it to. Even if it was my best friend, I probably would still do this. And he asks why I'm so nervous again, and he says, it's because it's mythical. And then he offers me $35. It doesn't matter the amount of money, I would still put it through the markers. Yeah, like I said, $100, no. And so he says, okay, you lose the chance. I lose the chance to get scammed. Yes, I'm happy to do that. To get $35. What? How do you get that? I don't even understand how he's gonna do this. Okay? Anyway, and he says, can you call me in Steam? And I say, well, no, because he's a 21-year-old. I don't want to talk to this sketchy 21-year-old scammer. And then he asks, so what's the point of buying from the racket? And I say, so I can get the money, you can get the skin on a price that we agreed on. And then he says, I can buy from another person. Then why didn't you do that? He says, okay, bye. And then he says, so now I'm scammer because I don't want to buy from you skin. Because your myth worth only $15 to $16. It's probably this point where he's realized they're cheaper on the market. And what he's offering me is much, much, much too high. And I would have taken it, but only if it was from the market. And that's right about where the scamming conversation ends, and then we go on to the actual sensible stuff that's not dealing with, you know, $30 mythicals and more like 60 cent skins and stuff like that. Anyway, I didn't get the rainbow party hat from that guy because he was really under trading me. And I would lose about 50 cents. And I kept on doing it for his. I kept on offering a trade where I'd still lose money and he would still gain money. But he didn't want to do it. And so I just ended up going to one of my friends and say, hey, you've got a, you know, a mythical party, I guess. You've got a rainbow party hat, do you want to trade? And I ended up giving this guy Compressor Echo for the party hat. So yeah, that's pretty much where it ended. One of the sketchiest trades I've ever, well, not have ever done because I didn't do it. But yeah, anyway, later on, I looked at his profile and guess where he came from? He came from Russia. He came from Russia. If you're gonna scam me, don't put your profile's location as Russia. That's the last place you would put it as. That's Oh man, he's so dumb. He's so dumb. Even for a 21-year-old guy, he's so dumb. Trying to scam me. He puts his profile, its location as Russia. And he plays CSGO as well. So I really, really didn't want to trade with him anymore. And that was just about where it ended. So yeah, that's really it. Anyway. Thank you for watching, guys. Hope to see you in the next video. But it's all for now. See you in the next one.
Nothing gets me any higher, and nothing ever will. Try to stay.